Okay, so this question is from the 1988 Australian Mathematics Competition, and only 3% of students got this one right. The challenge is to solve this equation for n. So if you haven't tried this one before, then pause the video here, and then come back to check your answer. Now, we need to get rid of these cube roots. So kind of the obvious thing to do would be to cube both sides of the equation, but that's going to give us all these cross terms, so we'll have to figure out what to do about that. But first, let's just review what happens when you cube something like a plus b. So you may have learnt the binomial theorem, or you may have just seen the expansion of this before. If you don't know how to expand that, what you can do is think of it as a plus b squared and then multiply that by a plus b. So if you do that and simplify everything, you'll eventually get to a cubed plus 3a squared b plus 3ab squared plus b cubed. So these are what's called the cross terms. So like with people who are just starting out with algebra, they tend to think a plus b cubed is just a cubed plus b cubed. I think probably everyone watching this video is old enough to know that you've got these other terms as well. Okay, so if a and b is that and that, these are going to be like messy and annoying, and we're going to have to think of a way to sort of clean those up. Like the a cubed and b cubed, they're fine. But what are we going to do with these? Well, what we could do is try to factorize this, because there's a lot of common factors there. I mean, you've got the 3, but you've also got the a and b. So let's see what happens if we take the 3ab out of that. Then we're just left with a plus b. So is that going to be nicer? Well, the a plus b is good, because actually this is a plus b, and we know that that's 8. So that is just 8. And the ab, well, let's see what happens with that. Maybe it's going to be nicer. I'm going to be honest here. I probably wouldn't have thought to do this trick if I wasn't already familiar with how Tartaglia solved cubic equations. This is like an important part of the history of complex numbers. There was this problem of sort of how to solve an equation that looks like this. And they worked out that if you let x be a plus b, then you've got like a plus b cubed. We know that that's this thing. So the 3ab times the a plus b plus a cubed plus b cubed. And then this is just our x again, like that's x cubed if we let x be a plus b. So you've got that is a p and that's our q. So that gives you two equations that you can solve simultaneously for a and b, knowing what p and q are. And then that lets you solve the cubic equation. So this was really important for the history of complex numbers, because when you solve these two equations, you get like a quadratic in A, so you have like plus or minus square root of something. And I think it was Cardano who worked out that the formula still worked if it was square root of a negative number, and he was able to actually get solutions to cubic equations even though you were taking a square root of a negative number. And that was what led to people investigating these things. So I'm familiar with that, which is probably why I was able to come up with that solution. So don't feel bad if you didn't think of doing that trick. But okay, let's see what happens if we apply this. So we're taking this, cubing both sides. So we'll get the a cubed plus b cubed, which is just, you know, if you cube this, that will just get rid of the cube root. So n plus root n squared plus a. That's our a cubed. And then we've got the b cubed, which is just this bit. And then we've got 3ab. And then actually, since that was 8, because a plus b is just this, which equals 8, let's just simplify that and turn that into 24. And then we've got the a times b, so that times that. Now, what we can do, if you've got cube root of something times cube root of something else, you can just, like, combine them both into the same thing. You know, like, if you've got cube root x times cube root y. You can turn that into cube root xy. So we could say that it's cube root of this bit times this bit and then, because I've run out of space, I'll write the right-hand side over here. So 8 cubed, whatever that is. Now, let's see what we can do to simplify this. So we've got an n plus an n, that's 2n. And then these actually cancel out, so already that's much nicer. Now, with this bit, we've actually got difference of two squares there. So you know how when you've got something like a plus b times a minus b, and you expand that, you get a squared minus b squared. That's difference of two squares. So we will get cube root of, so that times that, or sorry, a, not a, n squared, and then minus that squared. So that's just going to kill the square root. So you can get minus n squared plus a. So it turns out that that factorization did actually make it much simpler. Now, with this bit, we can simplify that as well, because the n squareds are going to cancel. So we've got cube root of just negative 8. Now, cube root of 8 is 2, so that's going to be negative 2. And let's divide both sides by 2. As well, because you've got a factor of 2 in everything. Now, on the left-hand side, personally what I would do is think of the 8 as being 2 cubed. So you've got 2 cubed, cubed, which is 2 to the 9. And then if we're dividing that by 2, we're going to have 2 to the 8, which I happen to know is 256, because I know my powers of 2. If you didn't know that, you can just do like, you know, 8 squared is 64, and then multiply that by 8 again, and then divide it by 2, or whatever. Okay, so we're dividing both sides by 2. We've got that, and then the minus from there, minus 24. So, because that was negative 2, and then we've divided both sides by 2, so that gets rid of that. And that's 256. Let's move the 24 over, so we get 280 is the answer to that one. Alright, let me know in the comments if you still have any questions. Give this video a like if you want me to make more videos like this. And next time on the How and Why of Mathematics, I'll be tackling this question. So stay tuned for that one.